How often do we pause to ask ourselves if the life we lead is the one we truly desire? Or maybe it's time to change our path instead. Hi there. In this video, I want to share an ongoing journey of self-discovery in my 20s, one that might hopefully resonate with many of you. Over the past 2 years, my life has undergone through significant transformations. I left my home country to go and study in a university in the United States, and I immersed myself into a vibrant new culture. But somewhere along the way, I lost touch with myself. I was so swamped with studies, classes, social life, and work, and trying to maintain it all, that I felt like I did not have enough time for self-reflection, did not have enough time to understand what exactly I wanted to do with the future. It felt like my identity was sort of getting diluted in a mixture of other people's goals, other people's ideas and expectations from life. And I was just desperately trying to find the authentic self, my authentic self. During my psychology classes, I first discovered the term of quarter life crisis, which is the period of intense introspection, which occurs in your early 20s to early 30s. And as soon as I learned about this term, I knew I had it instantly. I knew that I wasn't sure what my passions were, and I was trying to figure it out, and I was trying to figure out my authentic self, as I said before. It felt like I was standing at a crossroads and seeing no clear directions. According to one LinkedIn study that they did in 2017, around 75% of people from 25 to 33 years old feel like they have a quarter life crisis, which again says that if you're experiencing these feelings, you're not alone. This is extremely common, and I guess most young people have to deal with it. The feeling of being overwhelmed led me to think about the paradox of choice. In a world of endless options, making a choice can be very much paralyzing. This paradox applies not only to choosing the outfit for the day, but also to making larger life choices, like choosing a country to live in or choosing a career to pursue. It's very difficult when you have so many opportunities and you don't know which one would be the best in long term. There's this rule that really helped me with making decisions. It's called 10-10-10 rule. Here's how it works. When you face a difficult decision, split it into three parts and ask yourself how you will feel about it in 10 minutes, 10 months, and 10 years. This helps you eliminate options that will not be good in the long term and just makes it easier to figure out what you want to do. For example, this spring in college, I was thinking if I should take a gap year. So I decided to use this rule. Thought if in 10 minutes I decide to take a gap year, I'll be happy because I'll know that the next year I'm going to be spending in Europe. And in 10 months, I know that if I do this gap year, I will be in Europe traveling and enjoying my life, and I'll be very happy about it. And in 10 years, I don't even know what the impact of this decision will make on my life in 10 years. It's very much possible that this gap year will potentially help me to stir myself into the direction of the career that I want. It's definitely a win on three of the dimensions, so I did decide to take this gap year. So now I'm on this gap year exploring Germany with a new job, new culture, new country, and I've really been enjoying it. This whole European rhythm has given me space to realign my focus on the things that matter to me and the things that I find interesting. And if you're looking for perhaps taking a sabbatical, gap year, or any sort of pause from your career or studies, I would say you should embrace it. So travel to a new country, learn a new skill, just do something that is new and different. And I think it will definitely help you with understanding who you are and what you like. And an important thing to keep in mind is just taking time off school or off work is not going to help you instantly rediscover yourself. You actually have to have clear goals in mind of what you want to do during this period of sabbatical. So, yeah.
For
First of all, set goals for what you want to have done during this period. Set goals of what interests you want to explore, hobbies, career paths, and preferably do new activities or things that you've always wanted to explore but never had the courage to do. Second is budgeting. If you don't have a source of income during your sabbatical or gap year or a job or some savings, I don't recommend you do it because you're gonna end up being even more stressed and lost if you have financial difficulties. And the third part is regularly reflecting. I suggest journaling or maybe keeping a blog of your activities and your experiences because it always feels very nice to clean your mind space of all of the clutter that you have and sort of like organize all of your information in your brain into like clear shelves. And also in the future, when you're going to be older, you can look in these notes and see how beautifully all of these events have turned out. And although I love setting goals for the future, I realized that the events of life are so random that you just can't know what you're going to be doing in a few years. So I heard this great quote on one podcast, which says, don't ask yourself what you want to have accomplished when you're 50. Ask yourself what you want to do on a boring Thursday afternoon when you're 50. And I thought, wow, what a great way to think about your future. You're not just thinking about the milestones, but you're trying to figure out what are the ordinary moments that could bring you happiness. And I think this is actually the absence of personal fulfillment. So not focusing on the milestones only, I think it's very important because once you achieve one goal, you're gonna get used to it before you even know it. This quote of George Bernard Shaw really speaks to me, which says, life isn't about finding yourself, life is about creating yourself. It's a reminder that our lives are not pre-written stories that are waiting to be discovered. They're actually blank canvases, and we are the people who are holding the brush. So you are the person who are going to craft your story. And in this process of creating, we're finding ourselves. So if you're in your 20s and you're feeling lost, you're not alone. I myself am still in the process of overcoming this quarter life crisis, but with this gap year, I've actually had a much better time with understanding who I am as a person and finally having more time to explore my interests. The key is to understand that this phase is just a part of your growth. You're gonna get over it. And for me personally, it's been a turning point. And I hope this becomes a turning point for you as well into a positive direction. Thank you for watching, and I really hope that this video inspires you to start taking action. And if you are looking for that perfect moment or a message from the universe that will tell you to change your career or take a sabbatical or do something else, and you're looking for a message, this is my message for you to do so.